Today, I want to share my process of finding and choosing open source projects to contribute docs to. But before that, I want to talk about Google Season of Docs. Season of Docs is a new program by Google Open Source to help open source organizations and technical writers come together and work on open source projects. The benefit for open source organizations is that they get help from technical writers to create good documentation and make the project more user-friendly. And for the technical writers, I see three benefits. The first is to get started with open source contributions and eventually build your open source portfolio. The second benefit is that you get to work with a mentor. In my experience, the biggest challenge of getting started with open source is just that it's too overwhelming. And if you have a mentor to guide you and to help you along the way, to help you understand how GitHub works and how to make your first PR, that's an awesome opportunity. And the third benefit is earning a stipend. At the end of the program, Google will pay you a stipend based on your location if you pass the project evaluation successfully. I'm participating in Google Season of Docs as a mentor for Hydra Ecosystem, which means I get to help a technical writer make contribution to our open source project. So if you think that would be interesting and you would like to work with me, check out the links in the description box below. I'll also be happy to help you brainstorm the project proposal ideas. Okay, moving on to the topic of the day, finding and choosing open source projects to contribute docs to. The most beginner-friendly way to find a project is to participate in events that promote open source contributions. An obvious example is Google Season of Docs. 50 organizations are participating in the program, which means you have 50 options right there. You can also participate in the Writing Day events at the Write the Docs conferences. The second way I find open source projects is to go to project boards and forums. My favorite project board is upforgrabs.net. This is where I found the cover letter snippets project that I contributed to last month. I also love the Dev.to forum. They have a call for open source contributions every month. That's where I found Hydra Ecosystem. And the third and a slightly difficult way of finding open source projects is to search for doc issues on GitHub. I will leave the search query in the description box below. If you use all the three ways to find open source projects, you will end up with a lot of projects. Which brings us to our second question. How do you choose a project that is right for you? So when I'm choosing an open source project, I ask myself three questions. The first question I ask myself is, what is my intention? Do I want to create a writing sample for a particular type of document, like API documentation? Or do I want to try out a new technology? Or do I want to try a new tech writing tool? Once I know my intention, I sort the open source projects to find the one that best matches my intention. Then I ask myself the second question, am I the right fit for the project? Does my current skill set match the requirements of the project? And can I add value to the project without draining the time and energy of the project creators and maintainers? It is very important to remember that the project creators and maintainers are usually doing it on their own time for free. Like they usually have their full-time jobs and then they come home and then they work on the open source projects. So I want to make sure that I can add value to the project without having to ask them a lot of questions and add to their burdens. I love this blog post which talks about this issue in more detail. I will leave a link in the description box below. I highly recommend that you read this blog post. And the third question I ask myself is, does the team value good documentation? Contributing docs to open source projects takes a lot of time and effort, so I want to make sure that my efforts are warranted. And the way I gauge if the team values good documentation is by looking at the existing documentation. Do they have a decent description of the project? Do they have a contributing guide? And do they have contact channels listed which I can use to ask them questions? So that's how I choose my open source projects. To give you an example, let me tell you how I chose my latest project, Cover Letter Snippets. So back in October, I had an idea of open sourcing my tech writing process. So I was looking for a project that I can contribute docs to and also record my writing process. So I looked at the projects listed on the upforgrabs.net site and I found Cover Letter Snippets. It is an application that helps you create custom cover letters for every job that you apply to. I found the project to be very interesting, so I asked myself my three questions about the project. The first question I asked myself was, what was my intention? And my intention at the time was to find a project that was technical enough that it warrants good documentation, but not so complex that people couldn't follow along as I write the docs for it. And I thought that cover letter snippets matched that intention perfectly. The second question I asked myself is if I'm the right fit for the project. And from what I could tell, the project had like basic installation steps and then it was a UI software. I could handle it on my own without having to ask too many questions to the developer. And my third question was, does the team value good documentation? And I found that they really did. They had put in a lot of time and efforts into their README. It had installation instructions and screenshots and a contributing section. So I could see that they really valued good documentation and were ready to put in efforts for it. So I emailed the creator and asked their permission to not only contribute docs to the project, but also record my writing process. And they granted the permission immediately. And that's what I want to share in the upcoming videos. So in the upcoming videos, I'm open sourcing my writing process and I'm sharing with you how I write a document for an open source project. My writing process consists of three phases: user testing, drafting, and editing. So in next week's video, you will see me user testing the app. In the following video, you will see me drafting the README. And in the last week of May, you will see me edit and publish the README. And I have recorded the process in real time. So you will see me make mistakes in the user testing process, stumble through the drafting process, and then just question myself and my writing abilities in the editing process. If you think that would be fun to watch, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be notified when the videos are up. Oh, and comment down below and let me know if you're participating in the Season of Docs program and which project you're working on. And if you need help brainstorming ideas, let me know. I will see you next time. Until then, happy writing.